friends, how are you today? I am fine, and I'm guessing you are fine too. How was your week? Your Monday, your Tuesday, your Wednesday, your Thursday, and Friday. I had a beautiful week. In fact, I was just so happy. God blessed me with so many testimonies. I can't really share it right here, but don't worry, we'll get time to share our testimonies, okay? So today, like we've been talking about the life of Jesus, right? The life of Jesus. But before we go into today's topic, let's say a word of prayer. Close your eyes as we pray. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, we want to bless you. We want to thank you for all that you have been doing for us, for the food that we eat, for the air that we breathe in and out. Lord, we want to say thank you, Jesus. We want to give you all the glory for bringing us here again at your feet to worship you. Lord, we are happy to be at your feet to worship you. Thank you, Jesus. As we sit to hear your word today, Lord, give us a heart like yours in the name of Jesus. Let your love be in our hearts in the name of Jesus. And of course, amplify, Lord, that love that you want us to show to other people, our neighbors, our friends, and our families. Give unto us the grace to show love to them. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm really excited because today is a very beautiful Sunday. And I hope you came with your dancing shoes. So today, right about now, we're going to join the big church to dance. And I'll see you later. Let's go dance.
Down before you. so I can shout hallelujah. I can shout hallelujah. I can shout, shout, shout. So I can shout, so I can shout hallelujah. I can shout hallelujah. I can shout, shout, shout.
How many of you really danced? I danced. I danced so well because I like dancing. You can't blame me for that. And I hope you really enjoyed your praise and your worship to God today. Okay, let's back to business. We're talking about the life of Jesus. And today's topic is Jesus is crucified. Jesus is crucified. What does it mean to be crucified? Now, before we go ahead, like I did last week, We talked about we recited our memory verse before we went into the service, the real topic of today, because I want you all to understand why and how painful this journey was for Jesus. It was a painful journey because last week we talked about the arrest of Jesus. We said several things about how Jesus Christ suffered, how they betrayed him, how they punished him. In the end, what happened? They crucified Jesus Christ. Now, let's go to read our memory verse for today. And it says in Philippians chapter 2, verse 8, which says, and we read, it says, being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even on a cross. Again, we say in Philippians 2, verse 8, it says, being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even on a cross. That memory verse speaks volume. It explains to us that Jesus Christ was a man just like me and just like you. He had flesh, he had blood. He wasn't spirit, he was a man. He came to this world just with his flesh and blood, and he suffered. He even humbled himself. He died, even at the point of death. What happened? He showed love. He healed. There's no way you can discuss the crucifixion of Jesus Christ without talking about Jesus Christ as the healer. He healed. He saved. In fact, there was nothing that he did not do to make people around him happy. But guess what he had to do? Guess what the consequences for all of these things? It was death. Was it fair what he did to Jesus? Was he supposed to die for doing good? Now, let me put this to you today. So you have Shade. Shade is your best friend. You always work with Shade. She buys you biscuits. She helps you do your assignment. When you don't understand what to do, she puts you through to teach you what you don't understand in your civic education. And somehow, some people just don't like Shade. People just come and say, Shade, you did this to me. You did that to me. And they start beating her. What would you do as a friend? Would you stand and just look at Shade while they beat Shade? Won't you help fight for Shade? Won't you stand up for her? Because you're a friend, right? Because she always helps you, right? You want to do something to help Shade out of trouble. Now, this is what Jesus did. Jesus is the Shade right here. Jesus was helping people do good. And guess who stood up for Jesus at that point when he was about to be arrested? It was Peter. We talked about that last week. But now, let's talk about how Jesus was crucified. When you hear crucifixion or crucified, what does it mean? Now, it means he died. He was nailed on the cross. Now, his hands were spread out just like this. They put a nail right here on this left hand. They put another nail on this other right hand. And he bled. He bled. I can't even imagine what it feels like for somebody to pierce a pin into my hand and blood comes out. Have you ever tried it before? I'm not asking you to do that right now because it will really hurt you. But just imagine someone piercing a needle inside your hand, not deep inside your hand, just a bit. Won't it really pain you? It will. But look at what happened to Jesus. A nail. They pierced the nail and hit the nail with hammer and blood came out. It was so painful. In fact, they gave Jesus Christ a thong to wear on his, like a crown, but it was filled with tongs. Do you know what the tongue is? It's like, they call it something, like it's like a pin piercing down the crown, and he wore it. While he was wearing it, blood was coming out all over his face. You see all those things you see in pictures, you see Jesus Christ on the cross doing like this blood. You can only see it, you cannot feel it, because it was very painful. There's no amount of pain or how we explain it to you right now that you get the pain. You are not the person. But this person came in flesh and blood, just like you and I. So it would have been the same way we feel it if we were the ones in his shoes. Because he didn't come as a spirit. He came as a man. And he suffered. Seriously, he bled for our sake. So in all of these lessons that we've been learning since the beginning of this month, I want to believe that there is a purpose for Jesus' crucifixion. And it makes me so humble to pull down myself and say, God, if you have really humbled yourself enough to die for me, help me remain humble. Help me stay humble. There are a lot of lessons to learn in today's topic. Despite the fact that he was suffering, he was bleeding, he was neglected. People who he stood for denied him. Look at the story of Peter in Luke 5. Look at the story. He called his disciples, you'll be fishers of men. He said, Peter was saying, we've crawled all night. We're on the boat all night. We tried to put our nets in the water. There was no fish. There was nothing. We've been on this boat, on this job for a very long time. And all through last night, we didn't catch any fish. And Jesus said, put it again. And guess what happened? In fact, the net where he was holding tore. In fact, the fish was so much, it was so heavy to pull out. And when this happened, Peter said, oh my God. He knelt down to the feet of Jesus and said, I am not holy, I'm not worthy to be called your disciple. Let me just stay out. And Jesus said, no, you will not only catch me, but you'll be fishers of men. Peter was very close to Jesus. He was one of Jesus' disciples. He stood by Jesus. But guess what again? You cannot talk about the crucifixion of Jesus and not talk about how Peter denied Jesus. 3 times. As close as Peter was, Peter denied Jesus 3 times. He denied knowing Jesus. Imagine someone that who's your friend. Grace is your friend. Or let's just say Nkechi is your friend. And your Nkechi is in trouble. She needs your help. And they ask Nkechi, do you know Emmanuel? And Nkechi says, oh, sorry, you are in trouble. You are Emmanuel. And Nkechi is your friend. And they ask Nkechi, do you know Emmanuel? If you know Emmanuel, then we will save Emmanuel. And then you say, Emmanuel. And Nkechi says, Emmanuel. I don't know Emmanuel. And you're like, oh my God. You don't know me. Now it's time for you to help me. You don't know me. Nkechi said, no. I don't know Emmanuel. Don't put me into trouble. How would you feel? In your mind, I know what's going on in your mind. You'd be like, oh, you don't know me now, right? You don't know me now. Okay, when it's time for me to teach you, I won't teach you again. In fact, you're no longer my friend. That's what would be going on in your mind at that moment. Because at that point, you need Nkechi's help. But Nkechi, rather helping you, she denied you completely. Peter denied Jesus 3 times. He said, no, I don't know him. But you know what happened after all? Because Jesus Christ was sent by God to accomplish what God wants him to accomplish, he still found a way to forgive Peter. He called Peter back and said, come, let's still roll together. Let's walk together. You are still my disciple. Let's roll together. This is the heart that Jesus wants us to carry. Now, how Jesus Christ was crucified? They took Jesus Christ to the court. Now, let me put this to you right there. These are fun facts. Do you know that Jesus Christ visited 2 different courts? One, he visited the religious court. He had 3 different trials at the religious court. And he also had 3 different trials at the Roman court. Now, these trials, in fact, there was no attorney, there was no lawyer, there was nobody helping him. There was not even public defender. Nobody. Peter denied him. Everybody just betrayed. Judas betrayed him. So who was there to stand by him? Nobody. So imagine you, someone who is guilty. Normally, anybody who is guilty, they take the person to the court, right? Then he brings his lawyer to defend him and say, no, he's not guilty. But in this case of Jesus Christ, there was nobody. All by himself. And guess what he said? That was the most amazing word I would never ever think as a human being anyone would say that. At the point of death, would you believe that Jesus Christ still said, Father, Lord, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. That's so powerful. You need to really have heard from the Holy Spirit. You really need to have heard from God. It has to be God sending you to do this thing for you to have that grace to speak that way, even at the point of death. Normally, anybody will say, if I die for you, change my name. You know, how can you say I would die for you? Everybody should go and die their die. That's what anybody would say. People were spitting on him. They wore a purple dress. People were stoning him, crucifying him, crucifying him. Different voices. People threw stones at him. They used, there's something we call koboko. Yeah, they used it to wipe all his body. Every part of his body. He had marks on his body, like he stole. But in the real sense, what was he doing? He was doing good. He was just doing what God asked him to do. And the Bible also said he wasn't flouting the law. He wasn't going against the law. He was just doing what God said he should do. The purpose of his healing people on the Sabbath was because God wanted it to happen on that day. He was not disobedient. He was just going according to the rules and the regulation of the Lord, of God. In fact, that Sabbath day was a man-made rule. And he was doing what God wants him to do. So why would they arrest him? Why would they crucify him? They did not just like Jesus. They felt he was trying to take the place of God. Who are you to come and tell us that we should not do this? Who are you to come and heal people on Sabbath day? Who are you to tell us that you're going to destroy the temple? Who are you? They were so furious, and they had no other choice but to what? To crucify him. Nobody was standing for Jesus. He had nobody. The only person who he had was God. And then he looked up to God and said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. Praise the Lord. That is a very intense story, and I want you to learn some lessons here today. There's a lot of lessons for you to learn today, and it's about showing love and forgiving your friends, your neighbors, your family, everybody who has offended you one way or the other. There's some people in your class who stole your Bible. You know they stole your Bible. And then you said, oh, I will never forgive you, Shadi. Or I will never forgive you, Emeka. Or I will never forgive you. Anything they did or they have done to you, you don't ever want to forgive them. Why? Is it as bad as someone using koboko to beat you? Is it as bad as somebody piercing a whole nail inside your palm? Seeing you bleed, is it as bad as that? Yet, Jesus forgave all of them. Now, today, I want to make you understand this, that no matter what is going on in your life, you need to have a forgiving spirit. Just like Jesus had. Or Jesus has a forgiving spirit. Even till now, he forgives us. He has a forgiving spirit. And it's about love. He wants us to show love to our neighbors, to our friends, to our families. After everything that happened to Jesus, he didn't feel bad. Do you know that he still called Peter and he said, come. You are still my disciple. Come, Peter. He forgave everyone who did what? Who betrayed him. Who, one way or the other, you would have thought, Jesus is not going to have anything to do with Peter again for denying him. That's not true. He still called Peter, come. Walk with me. Walk with me. Praise the Lord. Walk with me. Jesus knew the goal he was sent to do on earth. And what he would bore the shame for our sake. He bore the shame for our sake. It was a painful experience he had to go through. He was killed. He was nailed. He was condemned. He was lied upon. There was no lies they didn't say about him. In fact, when the lie started looking like it was not concrete enough, they brought another lie to say, oh, this is what he did. Do you know that he said he was going to destroy this temple? Who is he? Do you understand? So at some point, I started to understand that it was not ordinary. It was not just a natural thing. He was human, but he had supernatural powers. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, number one lesson to learn from all of this is Jesus was not angry with the crowd. Jesus was not angry with the crowd. He was not angry with the crowd. He was not angry with the soldiers. The first thing that Jesus said when he opened his mouth to speak, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do. Wow. Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do. And that was the first thing he said. It was really, really, really a tough situation. But he had to go through it because God had a purpose for that event. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I hope you're understanding something today, and I hope you're learning a lesson today. Jesus forgave the people who threatened or who treated him badly, even though he knew he was going to be killed. He forgave them. Everything that happened, he has already seen it. In fact, he has spoken to God already. He said, let your will be done. Let your will be done. On this earth, let your will be done. If this is what you want me to do, if this is the cross you want me to carry, so be it. Let me carry the cross. Praise the Lord. He knew they were going to treat him badly, yet he forgave them all. Praise the Lord. He did not chase Peter away. He called Peter. He didn't say, stop following me. Stop being a fisher of man, of men. Don't go away. He forgave Peter, even for denying him. I said to you the other time, I said, if Nkechi denies you when you need help, would you forgive Nkechi? They want to kill you. They want to cut off your head. And then Nkechi says, I don't know him, because if I say I know him now, they will cut me on his head. Please, I don't know him. Do you know what Jesus did? He still forgave Peter. He forgave Peter. What does Peter mean? Peter may not even understand what he's doing. He was just afraid. And then he just said, oh, I'm sorry, I don't know him. Even at that, he forgave Peter. Praise the Lord. Jesus has power over everything. You need to understand this. He has power over, for the fact that he died, and it doesn't mean he was weak. He wasn't weak. That was what God wanted. So he's always acting according to what God wants him to do. Praise the Lord. If Jesus Christ did not die, think about this. It's a take home. If Jesus Christ did not die, you and I would not be alive today. Now, another reason, after reading so much about this, is the reason why Jesus Christ died was also to bridge the gap between God and humanity. So Jesus Christ came. You will realize that if there was no crucifixion of Jesus, there will not be a resurrection of Jesus. You know, the death of Jesus, the death of something, brought about the rising of that thing. So Jesus Christ died to what? To rise again. He died to rise again. So when we're dead in Christ, we'll rise again. So we need to believe God. We need to do what? We need to believe God. Most importantly, one of the very important lessons we need to learn. Some of us, when we commit one sin or the other, we are just so laid back and like, oh, he's not going to forgive me. I'm a bad person. I'm doomed. No. Most importantly, right now, this morning, I want you to know that Jesus Christ can forgive all your sins. Have you stolen before somebody's school fees? I don't know. That's a lot of huge money. I can only imagine, you know. But, you know, there's no big sin. There is no, whatever the magnitude of sin is, love covers it. So he's ready to what? He's ready to forgive you. He's ready to forgive you. So this morning, I want you to stretch your hands towards the screen and say, Lord in heaven, forgive me all my sins. Forgive me all my sins. I want to live a good life. I surrender my life to you today. Accept me, O Lord, as your child, as I accept you today and believe in you as my Lord and personal Savior. Because I know this is the right thing to do. I want to be proud to call you Abba Father. Help me, O God. Help me walk according to your will. Reduce that fleshy spirit in me, that spirit that always wants to show the bad side, that is not always wanting to do good, just as your word has said. Help me, Lord Jesus. Help me, Lord Jesus. Let it be your spirit that lives inside me. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. If you said that prayer with us, guess what? Angels are happy in heaven because you gave your life to Christ. So I'm happy to tell you this morning that you are now born again. Your prayers will be answered. The Lord would do that which he plans for you. But this is his will, that you give him, you surrender all to him. That before you speak the word, he's working for you. Praise the Lord. Now let's go back to our memory verse today, of today, which is Philippians 2 verse 8. Philippians 2 verse 8. Are we there? And it says, being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even on a cross. Philippians 2 8. Philippians 2 verse 8. Being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross. Praise the Lord. How many of you have learned something today? I have learned something today. I have learned that no matter what happens, no matter what sin I have committed, God, Jesus is ready to forgive me because I have given my life to Christ. And when I pray to God, he's going to forgive me through Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. And we come to the end of the service. Hope to see you next month. I hope you've been enjoying the series of the life of Jesus, the arrest of Jesus, and the crucifixion of Jesus, the triumphant entry of Jesus. I hope you've been able to learn something, because it's a very crucial moment, crucial event of Jesus. All of this story brought about the resurrection of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And come to the end of the service. I hope you enjoyed your time with us here. And see you next month. Bye.
Jesus hung on the cross. Jesus, His love has rescued me. Jesus, conquering King. Jesus, Your power has delivered me. All my guilty erased by Your precious blood. All my sins erased, now I'm white as snow. I have been set free by my Savior King. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. Risen King, Jesus, Your life now found in me. Come on. Jesus, light of the world. Jesus, Your light now shines in me. All my guilt erased by Your precious blood. All my sins erased, now I'm white as snow. I have been set free by my Savior King. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. All my guilt erased by Your precious blood. All my sins erased, now I'm white as snow. I have been set free by my Savior King. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. Hope of the world, Jesus, my freedom is found in You. Come on, Jesus, hope of the world, Jesus, my freedom is found in You. All together now, all my sins erased by Your precious blood. All my sins erased, now I'm white as snow. I have been set free by my Savior King. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. All my guilt erased by Your precious blood. Sins erased, now I'm white as snow. I have been set free by my Savior King. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. Jesus, Your grace is all over me. Thank you. Tracy's old.